Harper Business and Harper Audio present The Six Disciplines of Strategic Thinking, Leading Your Organization into the Future by Michael D. Watkins, read by Fred Sanders. A note before we begin. Don't forget to download the accompanying enhancement PDF from your audiobook provider. It contains illustrated figures from the book, as well as suggestions for further reading, and will be referred to throughout as the enhancement. To Katya, Love of My Life. Foreword. Strategic thinking has long been essential for leaders in business, government, and other organizations. The ability to anticipate and plan for the future, to think critically and creatively about complex problems, and to make effective decisions in the face of uncertainty and change is vital in today's rapidly evolving global environment. Recent developments in technology, globalization, and political and economic instability have only heightened the need for strategic thinking. The rapid pace of technological change has disrupted traditional business models and created new opportunities for those who can think strategically about how to leverage them. The world has become interconnected and interdependent, requiring leaders to think more broadly and globally about their operations and markets. And political and economic instability have created a more uncertain and volatile environment, making it increasingly difficult for leaders to predict and plan for the future. In this context, strategic thinking is becoming more important than ever. Leaders who can think strategically will be better positioned to anticipate and respond to these challenges and to capitalize on the opportunities they present. This book provides a comprehensive and practical guide to strategic thinking, offering a wealth of insights and tools for leaders at all levels. While the foundations of strategic thinking by leaders will remain essentially the same, the development of artificial intelligence, AI, will revolutionize how business leaders engage in it. With the ability to process large amounts of data, identify patterns, and make predictions, AI will help business leaders with new insights and perspectives that were previously unavailable. This will enable them to make more informed and accurate decisions and to anticipate and plan for the future more effectively. The implications for the future of strategic advisory work by consultants are vast. In the future, combinations of top leaders and AI-enabled strategic support systems will likely look like symbiotic relationships, where human leaders and AI systems work together to enhance decision-making, problem-solving, and strategy development. The AI systems will provide the leaders with real-time data, analysis, and insights that they can use to make better decisions and create better strategies. They can analyze large amounts of data, spot patterns and trends, make predictions, and help leaders identify and mitigate risks. They will also be able to simulate different scenarios and provide various options and recommendations. In these symbiotic relationships, leaders will frame the right questions and interpret the insights and recommendations they provide. As has always been the case, leaders will provide context and contribute creativity. Critically, they will have the emotional intelligence and political savvy to adapt and implement the results. However, as the use of AI becomes more widespread, it is becoming increasingly important for top business leaders to develop new skills in order to leverage these systems. This includes understanding the technology and the data it generates, being able to interpret and analyze the insights it provides, and having the ability to make decisions based on these insights. Additionally, it's important for leaders to understand the ethical and societal implications of the AI systems they are using. As you listen to this book, you therefore should keep in mind that the six disciplines of strategic thinking described here will remain essential and perhaps even increase in importance as we move forwards. At the same time, as you progress through the chapters, imagine how you will apply the ideas and tools if you are working with an AI system tailored to your company and optimized to work effectively with you. Introduction. The Power of Strategic Thinking. When Gene Woods became CEO of Carolina's healthcare system, CHS, in 2016, it was a well-regarded nonprofit hospital system located principally in North Carolina, with an annual revenue of $8 billion and 60,000 employees. An experienced chief executive with a track record of success, Woods inherited a strong organization with good margins, an AA-rated balance sheet, tremendous depth of clinical talent, and a long-tenured leadership team. On the face of it, it was a sustainable success scenario, but storm clouds were on the horizon. Healthcare in the United States was facing seismic shifts. Expenses were rapidly outstripping revenues, even in the most successful healthcare systems. Political turmoil was creating uncertainty about regulatory policy changes, and private equity firms were funding many new competitors determined to disrupt the market. Anticipating the challenges, the CHS board hired Woods to prepare the organization for the future. "I inherited an organization that was very successful under the old rules," said Woods, who was interviewed extensively for this book. "But where others saw success, I saw tremendous vulnerability." The U.S. healthcare industry was also going through rapid consolidation, a trend that Woods thought would continue. While not in immediate jeopardy, he believed CHS could not remain viable for long with its current business model. When he took the helm, the organization had management service agreements with other nearby healthcare systems. CHS managed these systems for a fee, but they were very loosely integrated. Woods thought those types of relationships were losing their currency, as they did not promote the sharing of best practice or create economies of scale. He believed CHS's business model had to become significantly more integrated to meet anticipated future challenges. CHS was at a pivotal juncture. "I foresaw that we would soon have to make hard choices about whether we could afford to maintain those loosely affiliated relationships," Woods said. "Also, although our core enterprise was strong and in a growing market, with the rapid consolidation happening, I could foresee being surrounded within a few years by other big systems eager to compete for our business. We needed to be the ones to drive consolidation in the region. If we weren't the convener, we would be the convened." That insight catalyzed the development of what Woods called his next generation network strategy. This was his vision of a tightly integrated regional network of systems with aligned missions and cultures that would compete with rivals by sharing best practices, leveraging complementary capabilities, and getting the benefits of scale. To lay the groundwork for realizing his vision, Woods built relationships with other healthcare CEOs and community and government leaders across the region. At the same time, he launched a transformation initiative within CHS to develop a new model for partnering and a more adaptive culture to support it. "We had historically been known for a top-down, we manage you, so do as we say approach," said Woods. "I knew that wouldn't take us where we needed to go. Culturally, we needed to evolve to support the new partnering model." Fast forward 5 years to late 2021. CHS, renamed Atrium Health, had grown into a substantial regional healthcare system with operations in North Carolina, South Carolina, Georgia, and Virginia. By joining forces with three nearby healthcare systems, Atrium Health increased its annual revenue to $12 billion and added 17,000 employees, bringing the total to 77,000. It was a transformed organization, poised for additional growth, led by a new leadership team and infused with an inclusive, high-performance culture. Joining forces with Wake Forest Baptist Health, a renowned academic medical system, complemented Atrium Health's clinical excellence with world-class research capabilities. The organization was well-placed to be a nationally recognized leader and spearhead the development of new healthcare models. Woods was not content to stop there, however. In May 2022, Woods and Jim Skogsberg, the CEO of Advocate Aurora Health, a large nonprofit system operating in Wisconsin and Illinois, stunned the U.S. healthcare industry by announcing their intention to merge. Approved by the U.S. Federal Trade Commission and state regulatory authorities in late 2022, the combination created Advocate Health, the fifth largest nonprofit healthcare system in the country, with 158,000 employees, $27 billion in revenue, 67 hospitals, and more than 1,000 locations offering clinical services. Woods and Skogsberg would become co-CEOs of the new entity, with Skogsberg announcing his intention to retire after 18 months, at which point Woods would become sole CEO. As the principal architect of this remarkable journey from a modest-sized local healthcare system to a national powerhouse, Woods exemplifies the power of strategic thinking. If you aspire to lead businesses, you must, like Woods, be a strategic thinker. You can go far in organizations by being a solid operator, but you will never succeed at the top without strategic thinking. Why? Because businesses that aren't led by strategic thinkers get outmaneuvered by those that are. Either they are acquired or they wither and die. Boards select people with strong strategic thinking capabilities to chart the courses for their businesses through waters littered with rocks and shoals. Every business today is navigating through such challenges. In 2013, the Management Research Group surveyed 60,000 managers and executives in 140 countries across 26 industries. The results revealed that respondents with superior strategic thinking skills, defined as critical analysis, thinking ahead, and planning, were six times more likely to be seen by colleagues as effective leaders. They were also four times more likely to be perceived as having strong growth potential within their organizations. More recent research by the professional services firm Zenger Folkman, publicized in 2021, but from a few years earlier, supports this assessment. In three separate studies, Zenger Folkman found strong correlations between having a strategic perspective and being promoted to senior levels. The bottom line? Strategic thinking is the fast lane to the top. If you don't believe you're a strong enough strategic thinker today, the good news is you can learn to become one. Leaders like Woods unquestionably have natural talent, but they have also worked hard to develop their capacity to lead organizations into the future. In this book, I will show you how. I will help you assess your innate ability to think strategically and learn to amplify it through experiences and training. What is strategic thinking? There have been many efforts to define strategic thinking, but a good description has remained elusive. When I asked more than 50 senior executives, HR leaders, and learning and development professionals to define it, their initial responses boiled down to, "I know it when I see it." They recognized that strategic thinking was a distinct and vital capability in senior leaders. Beyond that, things got fuzzy. For some, strategic thinking was the ability to take in a lot of information and figure out what is and isn't important. For others, it was being good at thinking through moves and countermoves. For others still, it was about envisioning the future. There were common themes, to be sure, but no comprehensive definition. The absence of a good definition makes assessing and developing strategic thinking ability very difficult. We can only design promising approaches for evaluating and strengthening strategic thinking by isolating the specific building blocks of this skill. The good news is that when I probed deeper in interviews with business leaders, common themes emerged. Distilling those insights, I developed this definition. Strategic thinking is the set of mental disciplines leaders use to recognize potential threats and opportunities, establish priorities to focus attention, and mobilize themselves and their organizations to envision and enact promising paths forward. In a nutshell, it means looking beyond the present situation and thinking critically and creatively about the many potential futures. Based on your assessment of each imagined scenario's potential risks and opportunities, you can develop promising strategies to move your organization forwards. The path to being recognized as a strategic thinker requires more than ability. It requires.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.